40 days after his resurrection, Jesus and his apostles gathered on the Mount of Olives. The time for his departure had arrived. The Lord had completed all the work he had to do at that time and was to return to the Heavenly Father until the day of his second coming. After instructing the apostles, Jesus ascended to heaven. As the apostles looked up to heaven, two angels stood by and said, "Men of Galilee, why do you look up to heaven? This Jesus, who was taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven," Acts 1 verse 11. From that moment until the present, Jesus' followers have been waiting for the second coming. The sign of Son of Man will become evident in the skies. When Jesus returns to earth, there are signs that will alert us to remain vigilant for. The Bible's narrative commences with the formation of the earth and culminates with the end of the world. The Bible is filled with verses about the return of Jesus, leading people to ask themselves, "Am I ready for Jesus' return?" Hebrews 9 verse 28, "Christ was sacrificed once to take away the sins of many, and he will appear a second time, not to bear sin, but to bring salvation to those who are waiting for him." What would we do if we don't know when it's going to happen? The disciples asked Jesus as shown in Matthew 24 verses 3-5, "And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many." In the book of Revelation, he provides a much more elaborate and comprehensive explanation. The disciples approached Jesus while he was seated on the Mount of Olives. This conversation is recorded in Matthew 24 verses 3-36. Within that passage, he outlined four distinct indications of his impending arrival. The initial sign pertains to global disasters, which include wars, famines, and earthquakes. The second sign of his return relates to the church, not the world. This brings us to the third sign of the end times, the distress in Jerusalem. Then, Jesus explains that the fourth sign of his coming will occur immediately afterward. This means we will have knowledge of his impending arrival and be prepared. When this sign appears, there will be no risk of false prophets or false messiahs. Deception will be absent, and the event will be swift. What will transpire is the extinguishing of all natural light. The sun will become dark, and the stars will fall. Matthew 24 verses 29-31. Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Numerous prophecies in the Bible foretell this. Isaiah anticipates it. Isaiah 34 verse 4, "And all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, and all their host shall fall down, as the leaf falleth off from the vine, and as a falling fig from the fig tree." People will ask, "What is happening? What is going on?" The sun, stars, and moon stop shining right before that happens. Then he comes on the clouds back to planet Earth, shining light into darkness. 1 Corinthians 4 verse 5, "Therefore judge nothing before the time, until the Lord come, who both will bring to light the hidden things of darkness, and will make manifest the counsels of the hearts, and then shall every man have praise of God." Multiple prophetic verses depict the celestial disruptions that will precede and accompany the magnificent return of Jesus. Joel 2 verse 10, "The earth shall quake before them, the heavens shall tremble, the sun and the moon shall be dark, and the stars shall withdraw their shining." How did Jesus warn us so that we would not be surprised by this event? The Bible says in Luke 21 verses 34-36, "Be careful, where your hearts will be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and the anxieties of life. And that day will close on you suddenly like a trap, for it will come on all those who live on the face of the whole earth. Be always on the watch, and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. As we wait for Jesus, how should we live our lives? The Bible says in Titus 2 verses 11 to 14, "For the grace of God has appeared that offers salvation to all people. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age, while we wait for the blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all wickedness and to purify for himself a people that are his very own, eager to do what is good." What will the world be like when Jesus returns? The Bible says in Matthew 24 verses 37 to 39, "For as it was spoken in the days of Noah, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark, and they did not know it until the flood came and took them all away, so will the coming of the Son of Man be." Will the coming of Christ be a time for rewards? The Bible says in Matthew 16 verse 27, "For the Son of Man will come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he will repay everyone according to their works." The Bible says in Revelation 22 verse 12, "He that is unrighteous, let him do unrighteousness still, and he that is filthy, let him be filthy still, and whoever is righteous, let him do justice still, and he who is holy, let him be holy still." Why is Jesus taking so long? The Bible says in 2 Peter 3 verses 8 to 9, "But you, beloved, do not be ignorant of one thing, that with the Lord one day is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, even though some consider it delay, but he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance." At the second coming of Christ, we will finally have the complete reality of our salvation. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 1 verses 7 to 8, "Therefore you do not lack any gift as you wait for the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ, who will also establish you until the end, so that you will be blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ." The truth is that trying to predict God's will is futile. It's okay that we can make interpretations, but that doesn't mean they are right. Holy scriptures can be used to favor any of these theories, but we will only know the truth when it actually happens. The fact is that all followers of Jesus suffer tribulations in their lives, but they just need to remain faithful to be rewarded. Perhaps you have already faced tribulations and even come across an Antichrist, but you need to face difficulties and be aware of false teachings. As we get closer to Christ's return, we will notice that the tribulation will increase. At some point, a deceiver will emerge who will seek to persecute Christians. You may not think so, but these obstacles are a way to encourage people to stay faithful to Jesus and God.